Hi friends, have all a nice evening. And on this evening I'm trying to open this challenge lock made from a Yale by Das Evers. It was in the package with the locks from Black Dolphin. Let's try to clamp that in here nicely. I have to tighten this really good. Okay, it seems to be free. So, I'm trying to pick this counterclockwise, clockwise, I think. And starting with a little short hook here. Okay. So, one feels loose. Two, binding a little bit. Okay, let's check three, some little clicks from three. Four, feels loose. Five, okay, a little bit of count rotation. Another click from five, and I can see still a bit of count rotation, okay. Another click from 5, but I actually don't know if it is a 6-pin lock or not. So first one is still loose. Second one. Okay, cord turned a little bit more on the second one. 3. Okay. It was almost an overset, I think. I will live. Leave 3 alone for the moment. Okay, we have a bit of count rotation here. Maybe a bit more. Okay, 4 set is back. 5. It might actually be that this pick is a bit too short. Let's try a deeper one here. First is loose. Second one is okay. Third one, here it's open. I just touched the third one with finally a use for my Matador, I think. Usually this is not the nicest pick. Okay, so I need really a deeper pick for this one. Pretty interesting. These Yale locks often have a bit nasty thing, and this is the key pins are resting here on this ledge. So usually I would pick it from this side here, but I cannot on this lock as the pins are so low and I don't know if there's a low pin. So I have to pick from this left side here. Okay, and it does have looks like a bendy clip. Okay, not the biggest fan of these bendy clips. I have some spare clips. Okay, let's get the pinning tray in here. Very carefully get that clip off. Always have to think where the key pins are. They are on this side. So I'll probably turn it a little bit. Shim and tweezers. Sorry if I bump the microphone cable sometimes. I've just ordered some new shim material. I'm really curious if it will work. Oh, we definitely have something like a T-pin here in. Shim does not want to go in. Let's play a little bit. Maybe a bit sideways. I just have to be very, very quick. Not too sure. I will try. try to be. Ah, no, please not. Ach, I was not quick enough. Ah, shit. Maybe. Maybe with a bit of luck, but I think. No, I was not quick enough. Ah, okay. So the gutting will be a little bit messy now. I have probably most. Okay. I think I can get. I can get the core out. Maybe. Maybe I can wedge. If I just had. Okay, I will try to get the shim in here from the front. Maybe I can save something. Not too sure at the moment. I'm sorry. Doesn't happen too often nowadays that I mess something like this completely. But it happens. Okay. Okay, so let's dump out the key pins. Okay. Oh, very, very nice key pins here. Okay, this was number 4. T-pin key pin. Very interesting. Okay. Let's see if it can do anything. This was really not planned to go like this, but it can happen. It can happen, and when it can happen, it will happen to me. Okay, I will get it out somehow. But I don't actually want. Even turn the damn plug here. Ah, there's probably something which is catched in that lip. Okay. What can we do? I have no other chance. I slowly have to pull out the luck and hope for the best. Okay, doesn't look too bad. This one is definitely the last one. Oh. Big mess here. We have a pin and pin. Ah, this was the spring. This is another spring. We have another. Okay, I can see what happened here. But I can probably save it. Okay. Yeah. I should have taken the time. Okay. But I think I got the order half decent right. Oh, there was another pin. So it is a 6-pin lock. Okay. No, it's a 5-pin lock. What did I do wrong? Ah, here, I see it. I see it. So this was definitely the last one. Here I have a T-pin. Another T-pin. This is the second one. Okay. Wow. Wow. I have no idea how we were in. which way around. Wow. Yeah, little mess. Sorry for that. But I somehow catched here at this lip. It can happen. So we have some threading in every chamber. Very interesting. Okay. On some chambers I will try to show it in the light, like the second one and the fifth one, there is only light threading. And the others, 1, 3, and 4, have a bit more. Okay. Probably can check the Bible now. Here's a spring. Left on chamber. Oh, a double spring on chamber one. So, okay. Have to reposition the springs two here. I think the second and third chamber are threaded. Yep. But let's have a look. Can actually look inside with a little bit of light too. So we can see it. The second and the third chamber are threaded. Yeah, I wish I could have used the lighted follower on this one, but the gutting was so messed up. Okay, but let's have a look at the pins. Wow, this one really looks very, very cool. I have to check if there are any pin and pins. Okay. I think this was this way around. This is just heavily serrated, okay. A lot of T-pin stuff going on here. Not sure if there's a wafer. No, but an inner threaded, I will show you this in detail. An inner threaded. Oh, pin and pin. Is it now? Ah, here it is. Oh, okay. Puh. As I said, if it can be messed, I will definitely mess it. Very, very beautiful pins. We have this awesome shaped one. I have no idea how I would call this. It gets very thin in the middle and then almost like a mushroom, a real mushroom. Very cool. Then we have a spool here, a Striver number 2, a heavily serrated T-pin in number 3, a pin and pin with inner serrations on the little stem here, and heavily serrated also here on the outside. Wow, and here double spool is driver number 5. Then key pin number 1 is a serrated T-pin. All very, very nasty pins. Wow. Number 2 is a standard, to my surprise. Number 3, a little mushroom key pin. Wow. Very nice. Number 4 is a little T-pin. And number 5 has one serration at the top. Catching very nicely. They have to get the... Oh, there was no key. I just wanted to try out the key, but actually there was no key. Okay. So I hope all the pins are in the right order. So I will reassemble it this way. If not, please just give me a little bit feedback when I will change it into a right order. Whew. Little bit messy, but we got it picked. Hope you had fun anyway. Thanks a lot, Dust, for making this log, and also Black Dolphin for sending it to me. See you soon in another video, and have a great evening. Bye.